see you.
Everything we needed him to be and more. So we come into this place but to give him glory, to give him honor, and to give him praise. Come on, church. Let's open our mouth and give him praise. Come on, let's open our mouth and give him glory, because he's worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the shame, the Lord is worthy to be praised. Come on, let's give God praise all over this house. But we should enter into his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. Come on. For the Lord, he is good. 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 And he's worthy to be praised. Anybody know we serve a good God? Anybody know we serve a mighty God? Anybody know we serve a just God? Come on, open your mouth and give him praise. Come on, open your mouth and give him glory. Come on, open your mouth and give him honor. Come on, he's worthy of this praise. Come on, he's worthy of this praise. Come on, he's worthy of this praise. It's Palm Sunday, so we say Hosanna. We say Hosanna. This is when God entered into the city, and we say Hosanna. Is there anybody here that's glad that God came to dwell among us? I said, is there anybody that's glad that God came and he took our place? He took our punishment. He took our pain. And so we ought to praise him today. We ought to give him praise today, because he's worth it. Church, y'all acting like God ain't did nothing for you. Did he wake you up this morning? Did he start you on your way? Did he give you the ability to dress yourself? Did he give you the ability to make it here? Come on, so since we here, we might as well praise him. Since we here, we might as well give him glory. Since we're here, we might as well give him honor. We might as well bless him. We might as well magnify him. We might as well exalt him. Come on, raise the volume of your praise this morning. Come on, raise the volume of your praise this morning. Come on, don't give God the same praise you gave him last week, but give God a greater praise. Come on, he did great things this week, so your praise should go up a level. He's been gracious even more this week. Your praise should go to another level. He's been merciful this week. Your praise should go to another level. He's kept you. He's provided for you. He's made ways for you. Your praise should go up to another level. Come on, with 60 more seconds, could you open your mouth and give God praise all over this place? Come on, somebody didn't have the ability to praise Him this morning, but you have your hands, you have your feet, you have your mouth. Could you give Him praise? You got 30 more seconds. Come on, open your mouth. Come on, church, open your mouth. It's better when we do it together. Come on, oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt His name together. I believe God is going to do something in this place, but it's only going to happen when we get on one accord. So can we take the last 10 seconds and bring our mind in and bless God all together? Come on, let's bless Him together. Come on, let's worship Him together. Come on, let's praise Him together. Come on, church. You got 5 more seconds. Open your mouth. Open your mouth and give Him praise. And give Him glory. Let's receive our praise team that they come this time.
Come on, put your hands together and magnify the name of Jesus. We call Him healer. We call Him savior. We call Him provider. We call Him Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, you are name. Hosanna, you're holy. Hosanna, we love you. Come on, put those hands together and bless Hosanna. Can we clap our hands? Come on, come on. Clap your hands, yeah. We love you, Hosanna.
We praise your Hosanna. shout Hosanna. It means Lord, save us. Anybody need some help? Can somebody shout Hosanna?
Certainly we honor the Spirit of Christ for his presence being in this place. Let's clap our hands one more time for God using our amazing praise team. Amen. We thank God for our amazing ministry, our music ministry. Of course, this is not just Palm Sunday, but it's also our Youth Sunday. Can we celebrate God for our youth this morning? Amen. And again, amen, we thank God for them because they are here. Amen. The future of Cathedral Praise is secure, and we know that God is going to do some amazing things with them. At this time, we're going to have our prayer. Amen. Amen. I was going to say, amen. We're going to have our prayer. Amen. By, amen, Brother Mike Ness. Then we're going to have our scripture by Brother Darius Owen. And then we're going to receive our welcome by Sister Dallas and Sister Jocelyn. And then we're going to have our youth choir. So let's receive all of them as they come. Please encourage them as they come at this time.
Close your eyes and bow your head. I pray that we can have a good Sunday, Lord Jesus. I pray that we can have a good week. We can all be blessed to have. Thank you. But I do hope we do be blessed. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
I'll be coming from Psalms 24, verses 7 through 10. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be ye lift up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord in battle. Lift up your hands, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory.
Good morning. On behalf of Bishop Paul Coppett and the Lady Brandy Coppett, we welcome you to CLP.
Thank you.
let's clap our hands for our amazing youth choir. Amen. Didn't they do an amazing job? Amen. We thank God for them. Jesus is the light. And they're shining within us. And the old saints, you say Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him, there's no other. Jesus is the way. At this time, it's time for the most important portion of our service. It's the reason why we should gather in this sacred space to hear what God has to say unto his people. Amen. So before we receive, amen, our preacher for this morning, we're going to have a video from our media team. So we ask that you turn your attention to the screen. And following that video, we will stand and we receive, amen, our preacher for this morning, none other than the elect lady, Brandy Coppett. So let's receive them as they come.
Women's History Month is a time to celebrate and honor the contributions.
Women's History Month is a time to celebrate and honor the contributions and achievements of women throughout history. Women have broken barriers, shattered glass ceilings, and made significant contributions to various fields. In early history, women could not vote or hold office in any state. They had no access to higher education, and they were excluded from professional occupations. We honor the achievements of women, and we reflect on the progress that has been made in advancing women's rights. Maya Angelou, the first black woman to have a screenplay. Madam C.J. Walker, the first African-American self-made millionaire in the United States. Coretta Scott King, the first non-Italian to be awarded the Universal Love Award. Ketanji Brown, the first black woman to serve in the Supreme Court. The first African-American Vice President, Kamala Harris. And the list goes on. Out of the ashes, we have risen from what was known as the weaker vessel to strong women. A strong woman. A self-confident, productive, optimistic, go-getter, unbothered by what others say or think. She's a survivor. A go-getter, confident, career woman not afraid to chase her dreams. Strong women make an impact on the world around them and inspire others to be their best selves. In honor of Women's Empowerment Month, we salute all the women of COP, mothers, career women, daughters, servers. We are strong, God-fearing women.
Together all over this place. Come on, if God has been good to you, would you open up your mouth and clap those hands and let heaven know that you survived, you made it through one more week? Come on, would you let heaven know or the devil know that what he thought was going to stop you? Come on, didn't stop you. As a matter of fact, it catapulted you to try just a little bit harder, to go just a little bit stronger, to reach just a little bit higher, to move just a little bit faster. And for the women in the house this morning, would you lift your voice and say, I am here, and it's by the grace of God. If you believe that, would you open up your mouth and encourage your neighbor and tell them, girl, you made it. And since you're here, you might as well give God what he deserves. Tell him, I ain't come to play this morning. I didn't come for shenanigans. Come on. I didn't come to gossip. I didn't come to be jealous. I didn't come to look at what you had on. I didn't come to think about what y'all said all week long. I didn't come to think about what I saw on Facebook that could have been taken about me. I didn't come to think about what somebody sent me in my DM. But I came for one purpose. Lift your hands and shout out till you take this roof off. the door. Why y'all stop so quick? Why y'all stop so fast? You gotta praise them like you on your last leg. You gotta praise them if this was your last time. If you ever get another opportunity, how would you give God what he deserves? Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah, that's what he loves. A praise that don't need a music. Because when the music stopped, he built an instrument on the inside of you. Hallelujah. Yeah. Oh, I feel God. I feel God. To give God what he deserves. You got to understand that your very next breath is predicated on his goodness. Amen. And at any minute, he can choose to snatch what he's giving you. So because of that, you give God what he deserves when you feel like it and when you don't. When you're in the mood and when you're not, that's just the kind of God we serve. I believe God is going to have his way in this place on this morning. Would you do me a favor while you're yet standing and clap your hands for the best bishop this side of the Mississippi? Amen. Bless God. Come on, y'all can do better than that. That's our leader. And we bless him for him. Amen. We thank God for him. Amen. And the God that resides in him has, amen. We have an awesome bishop. And I thank God for him. Amen. Why are you yet clapping? Clap your hands for these awesome leaders that stand beside him. None other than the persons of Minister Elder Gore. Amen. We thank God for him. Amen. Will y'all clap for Elder Hosey on this morning? Thank God for you, sir. Amen. Clap your hands for our mothers on this morning. Yes, we bless God for you all. Amen. Amen. Go ahead and clap your hands for yourself. Tell them. I made it, and it's only by the grace of God. Is that all right? Amen. There is a word from the Lord on this morning. I've been given a task, amen, to encourage the women on this morning. Not something, really not something that's hard for me, amen, because I enjoy, amen, women. Is that all right? Amen. And I love women. I know sometimes we may not always love ourselves, amen, but God has created us to be something really special, and I praise God for that. So men, if y'all can help me this morning, help us celebrate these awesome women this morning. Now if you got a wife in here, you should be screaming a whole lot louder than that. Amen. And while they're clapping, ladies, put your hands together and celebrate yourselves, and then do a little bit louder scream for your neighbor. Yeah. Scream for your sister, girl. Y'all know how I like to do. Tell her, ooh, that hair is sitting somewhat cute. Tell her, that hair, that 27 pieces, that lashes you got on. Come on, tell them, it's sitting real cute. Ain't that what they call when the little short bob, that's 27? Well, that's okay. Come on, tell them them pieces, that wig, that natural, them lashes you got on, them heels. Tell some. It looked real good this morning. Look good, look good. Amen. Grab your Bibles, grab your Bibles. There's a word from the Lord. Amen. We're going to go to the Word of God. If you have your scripture, you have a Bible. Amen. If you would stand for the reading of God's Word on this morning. If you don't have one, ask your neighbor, can I borrow it this time? And tell them if I'm going to let you do it this time. Amen. We've become so lazy because we have it at our disposal. Amen. But you don't go nowhere without your weapon. I see these men around here, they have their weapons everywhere they go. So as it should be with the Word of God. Amen. 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 We're going to be found this morning in the book of 2 Kings chapter 5. And we're going to read verses 1 through 3. Men, please excuse me this morning, as this message is, amen, dedicated to the women. But I'm sure you'll find, I'll pick y'all up somewhere in the middle. Is that all right? Is that all right? Amen. 2 Kings, the 5th chapter, we're going to go through from the 1st to the 4th verse. And if you would oblige me this morning and just read along with me. Amen. And it reads to your hearing. 1, 2, 3, read. Now, Naaman. By him, deliverance. Oh my. And the Syrian of companies, and had brought away captive. Yes. And one went in. Of Israel, and thus said the maid that is of the land of Israel. Amen. God didn't really give me a topic this morning. Amen. But just for a brief moment, we're going to say, look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you go girl. Tell him, you go girl. You go girl. Amen. We're going to try to work this real quick. You go girl. You go, man. Y'all take your seats in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, I thank you this morning for the opportunity to share your word. I ask now, God, that you be with me, cover me, give me accuracy of speech, excellency of tongue, that I may say only those words that you would have me to say. God, at the end of it, Lord, that you might be glorified, edified, and praised in this place. I give you all the honor. I give you all the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Now let the words of my mouth, the meditations of my heart, let it be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord. Name, amen. Amen. Would you do me a favor and holler one more time in this atmosphere? Tell them, you go, girl. You go, girl. You go, girl. Amen. Women of God, it has been given my assignment this morning to come and simply do a task that I find to be really, really easy, and that is to empower many of you in God. I must be honest this morning that I do feel in this day and hour that this task can be a little oxymoronic, and that I feel that in this day and hour, we as women would rather find it easier to tear each other down than to lift each other up. I have a problem with this, because even as I begin to do my own self-evaluation, Mother Moses, I begin to think of some things within my own self and possibly criticize myself over some things that I feel could be different within my life. I begin to look at myself from out my own lens and really begin to think that there are some things in my life that if I could do over, or that if I could change, surely I would. But then I begin to think about all of the goodness and all of the great things that God has bestowed upon me and that he has given me. Some things that make some people jealous. And don't get me wrong, I ain't boasting this morning, but there are a plethora of things that I believe that God has blessed me with. Many, too many really up here to start naming. But as a woman, I believe that because God has blessed me in the
way that he has blessed me, before I let any woman talk about what I don't have, and before I let any woman talk me out of what I know God has blessed me with, I'll give God a praise because of what I know he has already given me. I think Kurt Carr said it best. He said, I may not have everything. I may not look like you. I may not desire and have everything you have. But for what I do have and for this, I will give God a praise. Is there any women in here that say, I ain't got it all together? I may not have everything I want. But what I do have, I owe God a praise. If I'm talking to you this morning, would you open up your mouth and say, and for this, I give God praise. Hey, you got to understand now our composition. You got to understand our composition, Lisa. Our very makeup is very unique and it's very detailed. God was very meticulous when he put us together, to the simple fact that he designed us all different. And to me, it was just a show off of the power that he has, from our waist to our hips, from our head now, all the way to our fingertips, are the attributes of an awesome architect that designed and that created me from the dust. Y'all, and for this now, I give God praise. I believe I got some men in here that can attest that there are some things about your woman that you know only God had the power to do. Can I have some men to help me this morning? You know, when y'all looking at some of these women, you know that say, my God, only God could have constructed something like that. That's why I ain't never desired to be a man. Thank you, Bishop. I ain't never desired to be a man because I love how God has blessed me. He gave us, y'all, the ability to create life. Tell your neighbor, I'm an incubator, baby. I can hold something on the inside of me for 9 months. I can feed it. I can care for it. I can nurture it. And when it's time, I push it out and make it be what it's supposed to be, because that's how God created me. Tell him I can create and I can control any environment. I ain't not just a thermostat, but I'm a thermometer. When I walk in the room, I can turn it up or I can turn it down, because that's how God, don't talk me, that's how God created me. I got the ability to multitask. I can be a wife and a mother all at the same time, and whatever I'm in, I make it better. I accessorize it. I make it look good, because that's who God created me to be. I'm a wife and a helpmeet. Tell him I can turn a boy into a man. I can turn a house into a home. I can bring peace to any situation, because God created me just like that. And before I let somebody talk me down, Ashley, I lift my hands to God and say, and for this, I'm gonna give him praise. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, what you said for? You got a lot you could give God praise for. Now, I got any women in here that'll open your mouth and say, and for this, I gotta give him praise. Sit down, we just talking. Oh, sit down, we talking. Tell him, sit down. Sit down. Sit down. See now, I believe. Come on, Leisha. I got Leisha with me. I'm heading on home. I believe that we're not really giving enough credit, y'all, for what we do. I believe we ain't giving enough credit now for who we are. Because you got to understand, we've come a long way. We've overcome obstacles. We've overcome barriers. And the things that should have stagnated our growth, it didn't stop our progress. It may have taken us a while to get there, but it didn't stop us. We've gone through suffrage. We've endured degradation. And still, we've somehow arrived on top. We've been considered less. We've been looked as the lesser value. We've received lesser compensation and lesser rights. We've been forced into situations and to positions that we really weren't strong enough to carry. But somebody said, said we pulled it anyway. We've suffered emotional outbreaks and mental breakdowns, but we still became stronger. We became wiser. We became more confident. We became more resilient. We became more powerful. We became more influential. We became more fierce. We became more fervent. We became more passionate. We became more faithful. We became prayers. We became fasters. We became innovators. And before I let you talk me down, I'll give God praise. Look at your neighbor and tell her, go girl, you go girl. Go girl. You go girl. Y'all, we've done some amazing things, and we've accomplished a lot. We've become CEOs and CFOs of businesses and multi-million dollar companies. Ladies, we've been empowered. But if I be transparent with y'all this morning, it's this empowerment now that slightly worries me, Shanita. It's this empowerment that concerns me, because what I've come to realize, Macaria, and what I find the problem with is that when women have power, we want it, we desire it, some of us need it, but tell your neighbor, we don't know how to use it. Yeah. We want it, mother. We desire it. But in the grand scheme of things, we don't know how to use it. I tell you what I mean. He says, anything that you have that you don't know how to effectively use, you will abuse it. That's why some of y'all will allow them in situations with men, and you let them treat you any kind of way. Because he don't know what he has, and because you don't understand what's on the inside of you. Before you drop that joker, you or let him treat you any kind of way, instead of letting him know I am the prize. And if you want me, you gotta step up, baby. Stop getting beneath your means, and tell him if you want me, you gotta reach for it. Have this power, we desire this power, but we don't know how to use it. So God says this to me, Shanita. He says, anything that's connected to power always comes with instructions. I said, God, whatever do you mean? Anything that's connected to power always comes with instructions, because it knows if you misuse it, you have the potential of not only killing you, but killing the power source. Instructions are items that's needed before you start any procedure. What I found out about many of us women is that we start the procedure and read the instructions later. Yeah. I know I wasn't gonna get no help. Y'all start it and then you wanna go back for the instructions. Let me use myself for an example. So me, not too long ago, we at the house. I got some bar chairs that I wanna put together. So I say, Bishop, will you please put these chairs together? Y'all know how it is. Couple of days later, chairs still sitting. I said, would you put the chairs together? No, chairs still ain't going together. So what I do, I get the chairs, I grab them to the sofa. I take out the little Allen wrench and I start putting the chair. Yeah, I knew y'all was gonna help me. I got the chair. Got the chair set up, y'all. God, I said, oh, that looked like a nice chair. But when I sat in it, oh my God. Oh Lord. Come on. So I said, this is a casualty, because anybody that sit in this chair, it's gonna be harmful to them if they sit in the chair. Anybody that sit in the chair, darling, it's gonna be painful, almost to the point of falling, if they sit in the chair. Can I tell you, when you misuse your power, it can bring pain to those who are in effect. So here, got the chair together. Too embarrassed to say, you know, hey, I done put this chair together. Can you help me figure it out? So what I did was, I began to start trying to unscrew the chair myself. But let me tell you, you know, when you get a screw in there wrong, you get that thing in there, it's hard to pull it back out. So I had to go to Bishop. He said, let me see this chair. What God told me then, he says, when you have too much power and you misuse it, to correct it, you you have to be strong enough to create the problem that you made. And the problem is, many of us women have gotten ourselves in issues, and you're having to stay there because you're not strong enough to fix what you messed up. So I take the chair. Bishop took it, got the little screw, made me mad, y'all. He just a screwing on hammer ass. So then after I took back the other chairs and we were able to finish it. But I tell you what I learned from it. He says a lot of us, if you read the instructions first, it'll keep us from making a lot of mistakes. I said, God, whatsoever do you mean? He said a lot of us women have gotten in positions where we failed to read the instructions, and now we're living in a life without instructions. I said, God, what do you mean? He said, I created a woman to be chaste. I created you to be the prize. I created you to be the one who the man comes after. He says, but now you ain't doing the chasing. He ain't doing the chasing. You doing the chasing. You buying all the meals. You paying all the bills. You putting all the gas in. And that ain't how it's supposed to work. Because I read in my word, if a man don't work, he don't. So why you paying all the bills? You gotta read the instructions. Oh, I read. Mama used to tell me that women are submissive, not demean, but submissive. That we're sweet, sensitive beings, Kayla. But some of us have been through so much trouble that our heart is so hard. That we're so mean, like junkyard bulldogs. That anybody say something sweet and you wanna bite their head off. But that ain't how God created you. He created you to be sweet. He created you to be chaste. Why your clothes got to be so tight? Why you got to show everything you got? Why you so thirsty, like the kids say? Oh, but God said, I created you to be the lesser being. Oh, and when you get power, if you use your power the way I created you, you won't have to act for nothing. Oh, but anytime you walk in the room, everything you desire will be in your hand. You stop suffering from an identity crisis and get in your place. And when you get there, God said, I'll make men give unto your bosom. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, everything about you, God said, was good. And because of that, I will. Get back in your place. I wasn't gonna get no help. Thank you. Thank you for my help. Tell your neighbor, and for this, I will. Give them praise. Sit down. Let me walk this scripture for a minute. Here. I gotta take my time. I'm a little tired. Sit down. We just talking. So here, let us go to the scripture this morning. So I found myself, Maria, very intrigued this morning with the lesson of Naaman. Mom, doing all right? I found myself in the book of Naaman, where the captain of the host of King Syria. We find ourselves in a very, very sticky situation, because the Bible says it was the captain. It was this captain who was very infamous throughout scripture, Aisha. It was this captain in the army that led the people of Israel into captivity. You got to understand here and read it at your own leisure. But it was under Solomon's reign that after Solomon, 19 consecutive evil kings had ruled in Israel. And because of their unrighteousness, God now has placed them in a place of captivity. Now, although Naaman is in such a powerful position, putting the children of Israel into captivity, he's in a powerful position. The Bible lets us know that he had a problem. Somebody say he had a problem. The Bible would let us know that he had what we call leprosy. You ever met some powerful people that still had some issues? Naaman was one that had some issues. He's in a magnitude of messages across the nation, but he had had issues. He's discussed in Kings and throughout scripture, but he had an issue. And leprosy now in the Levitical law, if you had leprosy, it talks about the issues and the skin condition that was attributed to the people of Israel believed to sin. So it meant that if you had leprosy and you had boils on your skin, rashes, things that were incurable but contagious, it meant that you were in some way sinning, and now what you have is an indication of what you've done. Oh, what if God made us show everything we did? Oh my God. Some of y'all just need to throw your hand up and say, God, thank you for covering me. My God. So now he has this condition, and the Bible would let us know that this is what he had. Oh, but y'all, this morning, although Naaman is very important, see, I didn't come to talk about Naaman. He had a wife in the scripture who the Bible says that the maid was taken to come be the servant of Naaman's wife. And although Naaman's wife is very important this morning, I didn't come to talk about Naaman's wife. We had Gehazi, the prophet now, who went now and helped Gehazi get his healing after washing in a pool 7 times. The Bible says that Gehazi went and he didn't get anything to the king, to the prophet Elijah. But because Naaman didn't, Gehazi goes back and tells him, my leader says that you can give what you was going to give to him to me. And the Bible says that he was stricken with leprosy because he lied. But guess what, y'all? I didn't come to talk about Gehazi this morning. But though I did come to discuss this morning, was the little known name made that drew my attention. Tell your neighbor, you might have not a name for me, but God's eyes are on you. Tell them, people might not know your name. They might not know what you can do. They might not know who you are, but tell them God's attention is on me. Leisha, they might not know who the crochet queen is, but tell them God's eyes are on me. They might not know who Elder Goy is, but his eyes are on me. And that's who I came this morning to bring attention to. So can we walk the scripture for a moment? So the Bible says that it was this no-name maid, who little maid. Let's read it here. It says, and the Syrians had gone out by companies and had brought out captive of the land of Israel a little maid. So that thing intrigued me. I said, God, how can she be a little maid, but she got to be carried by companies? I said, whatever do you mean? He said, he's a little maid, but she's carried by companies. That is an oxymoron. I'm little, but I gotta have a lot to carry me. I said, God, whatsoever do you mean? So let me help you a little now. In the Hebrew sense means qatan. It means a small and unimportant person. It means one that is of lesser value. But if she's so small and of lesser value, why is it take companies to go get her? Come on, y'all, stay with me. Why is it that it takes a whole lot of people to go with her, Ashley? So I considered myself. I'm about 5'1", 5'2", 5'3", on a good day. About 107 pounds, you know. But so you mean somebody my size that you got to send companies out of? I said, so God, what is it, Tia, about this woman that she's small in stature, but you had to take the time to mention who she was? He says, because some of y'all got to understand that what you're carrying is gonna take companies to get you. You're carrying, Isha, it's gonna take companies to get you. So can I encourage you this morning and tell you not to ever let people minimize what you carry, because people are trying to make what you carry seem minuscule, but what you're carrying, it's gonna take companies. That's why people always trying to be attached to you. That's why you catch so much hell. That's why it seems like you can't never get it together, because the enemy knows you're carrying somebody's deliverance. And if he can keep you from what he got for you, that's just what he'll do. So he little more coming with me. Ah, I got some power. Because of what you're carrying. So here now, here, she's carrying. So the Bible says, now, that he sent some a company to go get her out of the land of a little maid. And she waited on Naaman's wife. Oh, I said, okay, God, you got a slave girl here. Y'all with me? I promise I'm going to get you to the end. You got a slave girl here, Tamika. Oh, she got a slave girl. And she sit there. Not to serve Naaman, but she sit there to serve Naaman's wife. So I considered this thing, Tanise. I said, you got a slave girl. You know anything about a slave? They don't talk. They're not supposed to be engaged with their master. They're there to serve. They're there to do whatever master say do. So I can imagine in my mind, she's missing her family. She's missing where she come from. She's missing how things used to be, because now she's placed in a place that she is foreign to. But all she knows to do is to do what Massa say do. So she's sent to serve a woman who's married to a man who has a problem. Oh, I said, God, what in the world? She's sent to a man to serve a woman who has a man that has a problem. Because you see, Naaman now in Israel, in the Levitican process, he's supposed to be quarantined because he's contagious. And in her custom, Naaman is not supposed to even be in her vicinity until he's cleared by the priest. So that poses a problem to her, because why am I serving someone who's not even supposed to be in my area? Can I tell y'all this morning, you better be careful who and what you serve, because what you serve can become an inconvenience and a liability. Oh my God, you better be careful. I know y'all weren't gonna catch that, because some of y'all serving things that don't become a liability to you. So now you're having to pay extra bills. Now you're trying to figure out how you're gonna get out of it. Now you're trying to figure out what you're gonna do, because you served it too long. But you better be careful that you don't serve something that becomes an inconvenience for you and a liability. You better be careful when you're in relationships, Jocelyn, who you serve. Because what I realize that us as people, we'll serve anything that look good. We'll serve up and serve anything. Y'all will catch that later. Anything that look good. But you better be careful that you don't serve the wrong things. Because when it becomes a liability to you, you can't get out of it. And it takes extra help to pull you out. Have you ever been in something that you wanted to get out of? Let's say it like this. Have you ever been in something that you asked God for, and when he gave it to you, you begged him to get you out of it, because it became a liability? So you better be careful who and what you serve. Oh, but I read in the word what Joshua said, choose ye this day whom you will serve. Oh, but as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Look at your neighbor and the name of who you gonna serve. So you gotta know now. I got two more points and I'm gonna get out of here. So you gotta know who you're gonna serve, Ashley. She's here with a man that has leprosy, that if she get too close, it might just connect it to her. And because she is, come on, because she is a servant, she's mindful of the fact that at any time, what's on you could jump on me. Oh, you better be careful that you don't put yourself in places that what's on somebody else jump on you. So she's here and she's serving. But now we find in the scripture, Maria, where she goes to her wife, to Naaman's wife, and she speaks up and she says, if my Lord goes to the prophet from Samaria, that he could be healed from leprosy. Now the first thing some of y'all would say is, well, who told her to be in my business? else somebody got your cure, you worry about why she in your business. But that's some of the stuff we would say. Why she all in my business? Who told her I had leprosy anyway? And who told her that she just a servant? She need to sit and do what she's supposed to do and keep her mouth closed. Y'all know I'm talking to some of y'all. That's what we'll say. But she took the chance. She took the chance, Sheila. And she went to my Lord. And she said, if my Lord, saying thus and thus, if she goes, she may be healed. So this is how it goes. The servant tells the wife. The wife tells Naaman. And Naaman goes now. And he dips 7 times. Y'all read it on your own time. It was a whole process. But the end of the story is that he goes and he dips. But what I loved about this maid, y'all, is that even though she was a slave and in an unknown place, she didn't forget where she came from. Because the prophet was in Israel and Samaria. And she told him, if you go back and see him, you might get healed. So God began to tell me, you got to understand as women of God, the influence that you have. Even in a desperate place, you still got enough influence. But I said, God, what it is about this lady that she would feel enough to even help him? Because mind you now, she's a slave and outside of her place. He says, that's how you know she had a relationship with me. Because even though they were trying to put me in prison, she still had enough God to pull you out. I said, Lord, what do you mean? She was in prison, but it was her words that was pulling him out. Is that some women in here that you know you've been in some desperate situations, but you're using your desperate situation to pull your sister out? I dare you, grab your neighbor by the hand and tell her, girl, I know where you are. Tell her, I know where you are. I know what you've been through. I can see it all over your face. How do I know? Because I've been there myself before. But because I've seen you in that situation, I got enough power, I got enough authority, I got enough faith to help pull you out of what you in. Grab your neighbor by the hand and say, well, you leave me, I'm gonna pull you out. I said, grab your neighbor by the hand and tell him, get out of there, because there's a promise, there's a purpose, and there's power, there's destiny all over your life. I dare you, lift up your hand, put your hands up, and say, God, whatever, whatever, whatever you got for me, I'm gonna get there, because you placed in me power. Tell your neighbor, and for this, I will give God praise. Say, yeah, say, yeah, yeah. Your mouth and give God what you owe him. There's some powerful, there's some exceptional, there's some mighty women in here, and you got to know within yourself that everything about me that God created, he said it was good. Your hair is good. Your body is good. Your mind is good. Your abilities, your stickability, your faith is good. Say yeah, say yeah, say yeah. I got to get out of here, but it's one more thing I got to leave y'all with. The Bible declares that all over scripture, they called this girl, they didn't give her no name, but it said this little maid, this girl. If you know anything about today's vernacular, every now and then when a story get good, y'all say, girl, let me tell you about this. You know how we do. harmony. Got something real good that you want to tell me. She said, Mama, come here, girl. Let me tell you this. I said, Harmony, I ain't your girl. I'm your mama. Don't talk to me like that. She said, oh, girl, I'm just playing. I said, okay, girl. Well, tell me the story. So, girl, she need a endow for me. Kind of rustle my feathers. Because I don't like the connotation. Because I feel in a little bit, Ashley, it kind of demeans the power and the authority that I have. But I changed my mind this morning because I read in the Word where the Bible declares that girl in the Hebrew, it means Nora. I said, okay, God, I start studying a little bit more. And the Bible declares there was only four women in the Bible who the Bible talked about and called them girl. The first one was Rebecca in Genesis, the 24th chapter. The second one, oh, come on, Jesus. The second one was Ruth, who came out the lineage, good God Almighty, of Jesus, and was the mother to David. The third one was Esther, who the Bible declares that she pulled her people out of exile. And the last one, somebody say, the last shall be first, and the first shall be last. The last one was this little maid who they called girl. Can I tell you, God is about to blow your mind. Tell your neighbor, you go, girl. Where I'm going, wherever he lead me, I'll follow. Where I'm going, he'll be a lamp to my feet and a light unto my path. Where I'm going, high. I shall reap and not faint, because his power is on the inside. Where we going? Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. Where we going? We're going to a building, not named. Where we going? Up, up, up. Where we going? Up, up, up. Where we going? You go, girl. Tell your neighbor. You go, girl. Tell your neighbor. Tell your neighbor. Clap your hands. Tell your neighbor. We're going higher. I gotta get out of here. But I gotta leave y'all with this last thing. I said, God, howsoever was she able to remember all of this while she was in a place of slavery? How was it, thank you, Lord, that she was able to remember this in a place where she wanted to give up? How was she able to remember you, God, when she was in a place of struggle? How was she able to remember who you was when she wanted to give up? When she cried in the midnight hour, when she wanted to take her own life, when she didn't see how she was gonna make it, her mother left her, her husband walked out on her, my daddy touched me. How is it I'm in a place of slavery that I don't know how I'm gonna pull myself out of it? Able to remember, yeah, so who you was, yeah, God, while she was in a place that she needed her own deliverance. She was in a place that she needed her own breakthrough. I said, God, whatsoever do you mean? He said, Brandy, take it back to the beginning. He said, you remember when I created her I put Adam to sleep and I started to form her out of his rib. I said, God, what do you mean? He told me this this morning when I got out the shower. He said, I put Adam to sleep and as I created her, it was just her and me. I said, when I created her, nobody else. So she was able to see the power that I had. She was able to see everything that lied on the inside of me. And when I breathed into her, God said it was just her and me. Just you and God. Just her and me. Just me and God. Can I tell you? God told me to tell you this morning. Forget about what you're going through. Forget about what you're dealing with. Forget about where you are. Forget about what you're facing. And remember, it's just you and God. Y'all didn't feel it like I felt it. It's just me and God. As the old saints used to say, just me and Jesus. I tell you, clap your hands. You and me now, do what you wanna do. Have your way in my life. Have your way in my situation. Have your way in everything that concerns me. Put his name on your situation. Put his name on your trial. Put his name on your trouble. And watch God show up. He said he'd give you serpent, you'll bruise his head, he'll bruise your heel, cause we got power. Somebody say power, power to speak to the mountain and tell it to be cast into the sea. Power, power that anything that you ask in his name, it shall be given. I dare you, I dare you, open your mouth. God, it's just you and me. Have your way. Whatever you need, whatever you desire, snatch it out. Whatever is beyond for the asking. Say, Lord, have your way. Move how you want to move. Do what you want to do. Touch me all over again. You created me, and I will give you glory. I will give you praise. So open up your mouth and let them clap your hands. Say yes, I love you. Say yes, I need you. Say yes, I can do it. Say yes, I can have it. Say yes, I can become it. You can do it. You can do it. That one.
yourself. You don't want to talk to anybody. You're aggravated with everything. God said, in this atmosphere, if you ain't give God a sincere praise, he is going to break the cycle this morning. That no longer will you deal with this. It ain't going to take no 30-minute cycle. It ain't going to take no pills. God said, it's in your feet. And it's not just women, but it's the men in here. If you put your feet on the floor, God's going to heal you, brother. I tell you, give God praise right now. God, lift those hands and worship him right there. Come on. You know you've been through some things that should have taken you out of here. But because God is who he is, he can't lie. If he said it, it's got to happen. If he spoke it, it will come to pass. So it doesn't matter what you face in life. I heard the scripture say, if God be for us, who can be against us? Lift your hands and first let's tell God thank you just for being there. Tell him for being there all the time. Tell him thank you for even when I couldn't trace you, that I knew you were there. Come on, he was there all the time through every struggle. Tell him through every heartache, through every disappointment. You got to learn how to praise God through it. Don't get stuck in it, but praise him through the wood. Come on, through the hard times. When people lie on you, when they turn their back on you, when you feel like nobody sees you, can you just still say, God, for this I will give you praise? That's maturity. When you don't just praise them in the good times, but you praise them when you feel like you're locked up. this morning. But there's some men in here, and particularly also, that you know if it had not been for the Lord who was on your side, we bless God this morning just for his presence. His presence cures everything, every sickness, every disease, every struggle, every issue. There's nothing God's presence can't control. So we thank God this morning for his presence. And at the end of it, we'll declare, God, no matter what we go through, our declaration shall be, we'll give you praise. Through highs and lows, debts, no matter what it is, we shall give him praise. If that's your declaration this morning, I want you to put your hands together and sound off like a siren and tell God, I will give you praise. A good God. Amen. What better time than to ask, is there anybody in this place that said, God, I just want to give my life to you. After all that I've been through, I want to give my life back to you. He's the only true friend I know. Never leave you nor forsake you. Everything that you need, he has it. Is that all right? Amen. If anybody, I offer Christ to you this morning. Everybody standing on your feet, we offer Christ. Anybody want to give their life to Christ this morning? Amen. So if God come today, we're all squared away. Is that right? Amen. If that be the case, come on, let's put our hands together and bless him. It's offering time. Amen. Let us prepare to be givers in the house of the Lord. I pray you all got something this morning. Something to help you encourage your spirits. Amen. Get that offering together. Amen. And I want to challenge you this morning to give God what he deserves based on how he's kept you. Amen. Don't get quiet now. This is one of the best forms of worship. This is where I find my blessing. God, ain't that right, Sebastian? Yeah. So get that offering that's sufficient, amen, for how good you know God's been. You know God pulled you out of debt. You surely shouldn't be bringing him a dollar. And if that's all you got, it would be like the widow. Said, I'm going to give my last and I'm going to go die. But God knows. When you get that offering, you stand to your feet. We're going to be givers together in the house of the Lord. We're going to read our financial faith confession together. Hallelujah. The presence of the Lord is still in this place. It's heavy. Thank you, Jesus, for this. We give you praise, God. We thank you. Thank you for your presence. Thank you, God. Ma'am, can I tell you something? Lift your hands right here. God said that there's a special blessing that he has prepared for you. He said, because your heart is pure and many people may overlook you because of your subtle demeanor. But God says, my eyes are on you. And see, he says, I'm going to bless your hands to be able to play and to purchase whatever it is that your heart can desire. He said, if you think it, I'm going to allow it to happen because I can trust you with it. Pray now that God will increase in every way that you need, not just materialistic, but spiritually as well, and that you will trust him. He's going to have you to do something that's going to seem outlandish, and it's going to seem strange, and you're going to be at a place where you're saying, God, is this really you? Trust God, and I tell you, he is going to blow your mind. I hear him saying that there is a place for you. I don't know what that means, but he says, I have a place prepared. I don't know if you're trying to move. I don't know if you just move. I don't know what it is, but God says, I have a place prepared for you, and he's going to give it to you. And when you get it, it will not cause you any harm. It won't cause you any harm, and it won't cause you any trouble. But this is going to be easy, and I decree and I declare that it is so in Jesus' name. Amen. Would y'all lift your hands for? Okay. Come on. Let's read our financial faith confession together, and it reads, Lord, greater finances. This is good ground, and it shall produce a greater return. I speak debt cancellation, wire transfers, promotions, increase, and money in my hands right now. This seed is going to come. Amen. You know the hands of the Lord. Bring your offering cheerfully up to the Lord.
Oh, a standing ovation. Somebody ought to stand on your feet.
Good morning. I'm Trinity Coppett. It's you Sunday, and I hope you enjoyed our service today. But first, here's your COP Kids News.
It's time for COP Kids News.
Easter practice for speech and math will be on every Wednesday until Easter.
We are now taking candy donations for our upcoming Easter egg hunt.
And also, the Easter egg hunt will be on March 30th at 12 p.m.
Get ready for our youth explosion on April 5th at 7 p.m. Invite your family and friends. All youth will be a part of the service.
That's all for COP Kids News.
Thanks. Parents, keep all those announcements in mind and bring your kids out because our youth department rocks. Do you love singing or just love being a part of a choir? Well, our music department has something just for you. Here's Miss Ashley with more.
Praise the Lord, COP. This is Sister Ashley. I am here to let you guys know about our COP Spring Music Workshop that is happening at the end of the month on March 30th. Yes, this month, there's a QR code right there. I need you to pick up your phones right now. Scan the QR code so that you can register. Why? Because we're serving breakfast from 9:30 to 10 a.m. And we want to be able to feed everybody, but not overfeed anybody. So register right now. At 10 o'clock, that's when we'll start the classes. These classes are going to teach us how to harmonize with each other and how to blend with each other when we're singing. All my leaders out there, you want to know the secret to ad-libbing and how to flow when you're doing it? Please come to the workshop. We're going to talk about that too. So that's March 30th, starting at 9:30 COP. Let me see you there.
I hope you scanned that QR code. And if you didn't get to that during her announcement just now, I'm going to give you one more chance to do it. Scan the QR code on your screen so you can be part of our workshop and sing on Easter Sunday with us. Speaking of Easter Sunday, join us next Sunday for our resurrection celebration at 9 a.m. If you don't have Easter outfit, that's okay. Come as you are and let's celebrate our Savior together. If you can't make morning service, then don't worry. You can catch us at our new location in Renz, Georgia. It's our launch service and we want to see you there. We're growing and we want you to be a part. The address is on your screen, so spread the word. Service begins at 11:30 a.m. Here at COP, there is always something going on that you can be a part of. So here's Miss Francesca with more.
Thanks, Trin. As she said, we are growing, and with growth comes more activities and more things to get involved in. So here's more. There will be a men's meeting on Saturday, April 6th at 10:30 a.m. Please be in attendance. Join Elect Lady at the House of God Church of God in Christ in Thompson, Georgia for their women's conference. That's Friday, April 19th at 7:30 p.m. The theme is Praying, Pressing, and Proving. The address is 441 Jackson Street in Thompson, Georgia. Elect Lady will also be speaking at New Generational Beginning Ministries in Montrose, Georgia on March 30th at 11 a.m. for their Women's Empowerment Service. The theme is Trials, Trauma, and Triumphs. The address is 4504 Highway 80 West, Montrose, Georgia. Let's stay connected with the ministry of Elect Lady Brandy Coppett through her Lady Become Ministry. Here are the ways that you can stay connected. God called me to be.
You like me, cause I love me. Do you like me?
Mark your calendars and get ready to join the Prize Singles Ministry for First Date Fellowship. On Friday, April 26th at 6:30 p.m. The topic is, I Like Me. Information about location of the event is forthcoming. For more information, see Sister Lisa Harris. Family and Friends Day is approaching, and Bishop would like for everyone to have on the COP 302 Experience shirt or COP Augusta You Belong Here shirt. So, orders are due by April 7th. $15 for adults, $10 for kids. Cash up your money to $COPRINS. In the memo, include your name, size, and t-shirt choice. Intercessory prayer is every Sunday at 8:45 before our 9 a.m. service and on Wednesdays at 6:30 p.m. before Bible study. Habakkuk 2 and 3 says, "For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, and that time is here." As stated earlier in our broadcast, Launch Sunday for COP RENS is next Sunday. After months of renovation, pulling up carpets, tearing out pews, electrical work, and wiring, our RENS sanctuary has made a complete transformation. Many thanks to all who have helped our bishop fulfill his vision. Many hands make light work. And if you would like to give a donation to be a blessing to COP RENS, you can cash up your money to $COPRENS. Put your hands together and clap your hands for all the wonderful things that God is doing at the Cathedral of Praise. COP RENS, a church for the whole family. Sundays at 11:30 and Tuesdays at 7. Campus pastor is Elder Marquise Gore. Here at COP, we are a ministry of excellence, and we believe in doing all things in decency and in order. So we have a few service reminders to help our service run more smoothly. We ask that there be no walking during the prayer, no walking during the scripture, and we ask that you minimize walking during the sermon, as this can be a distraction to our bishop while he's preaching. And if you have to leave before the benediction, feel free to sit in the balcony, so that there is not a lot of traffic at the door and you're not a distraction to those who stay. We appreciate your support and we thank you so much for your obedience.
All right, Trent, I'm going to toss it back over to you to close us out. Like she said before, we have so much going on. You really don't have an excuse to not get involved. You have lots to choose from, so make sure you get involved. Back to you, Trent.
Visitors, we hope that you enjoyed our service today, and feel free to join us again. And if you're looking for a church, you don't need to look any further, because you belong here, and we would love to help you grow. That's all we have for today. I'm Trinity Coppett, and this has been COP News. Happy Sunday!